What's up, everybody? Welcome to IGN Plays Live. My name is James Duggan. This is Vincent Genito.
Hey!
And we are playing The Darkest Dungeon.
The Darkest Dungeon. You remember our venerable house.
Oh, look.
Hey!
Problems already.
Yeah!
Hit that alt-enter joint. There you go.
There you go.
So, during this whole stream, if you have any questions or comments for us, you can tweet at us with the
hashtag
IGN Plays Live. So tweet at IGN with the hashtag IGN Plays Live. I will also be checking our Twitch chat as well as our YouTube stream chat. Let's have a real nice time in the Dankest Dungeon.
Yes, the dankest of all the dark dungeons
ever.
The
Dankest Dungeon.
If this will... Please. What is this thing doing right now? What are you doing?
That hashtag was great.
That was pretty good. That was on point. That was on point. I don't know what the game is doing right now. What's that? Yes.
Oh, okay. Here, let me try this. Let's get this sorted.
Okay. Sorry.
Well, first things first.
Technical difficulties. I'm really surprised that they haven't
fixed this yet. Oh, it's just, look, you can click. Oh, no. Oh, yeah.
Nope,
okay.
Just kidding.
All right, fine. So I go to my, what do I do? Yeah.
What if we just restart the game? Wasn't that, will that just fix it?
This is how you. I can't even click that. Oh, there we go. Oh, see, that's what it is. It's because it's like
It's not lined up. Yeah, which would make it pretty funny to try to play Darkest Dungeon is hard enough on its own.
It is.
It'd be pretty funny trying to play it. Where?
Good thing I'm a PC gamer.
Good thing.
Because I'm not even stressing right now. All right, so
I'm not stressing. I'm chilling.
Personalize.
I play the PC games.
Change desktop icons. Our Twitter handles
That's
are
right.
Up
We're getting more famous by the minute.
You should tweet at us.
That's right. If
with
you
the
love if you
hashtag.
The hashtag. If you love the content you're seeing right now, guys, if you love this riveting Windows settings content, please
change the size of all items. Is that what you want me to do?
Yes. Please follow me at Vincog.
Scaling levels for all my items. Okay, apply. Is that it? Yes. Sign out later. Well, I don't know.
Sign out never.
Change
Damn
display
it,
settings.
Windows.
Is there anything else? Can you see any of this, Ben? So that's in, all right, I think I got it. I hit change display settings and then, all right, well, let's try it.
Hey, guys.
Probably full screen this as well.
If you haven't left us by now, thank you.
Yeah, thanks for sticking with us here. We're going to have a real good time.
I swear it'll be fun
dungeon.
once I can play the game.
Ruin has come to our... But? Arrows? Oh, yeah. It's gonna be real difficult to click. Aha!
No.
Let's do this. Actually, hold on.
What is even going on?
I think. Yeah.
I've literally never had this happen to me.
Yeah. Maybe we can just Let's. Okay, so we got to figure out where about our mouse is.
So this is actually the meta thing about Darkest Dungeon is that it even screws with you when you're in the menus. It tries to
Here we go.
It tries to find any way it can to beat you.
Full screen. Hmm. So the full screen should be a check. How are your guys' days going?
Because ours is off to a rousing start. Let us
know. All right. I'm going to consult the chat for fixes here in a second.
Here's something we can try while you're consulting the chat. Let's not do that. I can't play like this. So.
You can play like that. You just have to envision with your mind.
This should be interesting.
Yeah, this should be.
Who wants to over-under on whether or not...
Oh,
my God.
You're in the middle of a dungeon.
I was in the middle of a dungeon.
Well, I hope you don't lose all your people.
Well,
so you could just use the controls.
I could
without the mouse.
I've never actually used them. This is great. No, I know something that we could actually do. I'm gonna give it a try real quick.
Do it. Welcome to Vince's Steam. This is all of his information.
Everyone, please pay close attention.
Oh, nice. Can we see this? Can we see how many laptops I have to fix this problem?
So I'm going to turn off the Steam overlay.
Okay.
Because that caused a lot of problems.
Control panel, then display, make text and other items larger or smaller, change size of all items, not set to 100. Returning the setting to 100 will fix the issue. Okay, so I brought it down. So if we go to... here, I got you.
Where are we going?
Personalize? I have not had this problem, personally. So change desktop
I have a funny
icons,
way.
Right?
I am so good at causing these problems.
Yeah, you're really good. It's our work computer. All right, so. Display. So
here I thought the hardest thing about this Smaller. Stream was going to be me trying to survive veteran-level dungeons. That's right.
So I have I have 100, which is what it was set to. Let's try 125. Apply. All right. I guess we'll just sign out now. Welcome to the darkest stream. All right. Do your password. Are we okay? Maybe if I.
Your laptop juggling skills are impressive.
Wyatt Beaver says hi. What's up?
Razor Wizard has stopped working. I don't care. Shut your dumb mouth, Razor.
Things can only get lighter from here. Our torch is at zero right now.
Yep. Yarp. Come on. Come on.
Yo, where my Twitch chat at? Let me get a what Twitch chat.
Ruin has come to our stream.
All right, this is looking better. Maybe. We did it.
Hey!
It's time. All right, here, you take this laptop back.
All right. Now
shout out to our producer Ben. Thanks for
And to the stream for sticking with us. Thank you guys.
I'm going
to
start
gals.
Drinking already. It's already time. Yeah, to start
it's definitely time to take a drink. And now let's see if I can deal with this trash fire of an encounter. I apparently quit in the middle of because I was probably mad that I was about to lose my Crusader.
Yeah,
I'm totally about to lose my Crusader.
I mean, you could battle heal him.
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. He'll live maybe another turn.
Off Death's Door. I had a guy who got hit maybe like 6 times in Death's Door.
Finally
he went down.
People don't realize that your starting resistance is to Death's Door is pretty high. It's 67. So
the bleeds,
really
suck.
Yeah, you got
Death's
a 2 in 3 chance of living. And we're gonna finale. I love finale so much.
It's not gonna crit. I'm calling it.
It's probably not gonna crit.
Really gotta stack that crit chance. Ooh, you have the what is it? I thought that was an Oculist only item on him.
No. Oculist? Okay. You mean occultist?
Yeah.
Oh, of course you dodged.
I told you. Yeah. Should have listened to me, but oh well. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Darkest Dungeon. So for those of you who are not aware, or maybe playing on consoles and don't have a PC or Steam, this is a turn-based role-playing game like no other.
You got that right.
It is oppressive. It is glorious.
Yes, I love this game.
And it is very unique. So the idea here, a little bit of flavor, is that we receive a letter from our uncle, grandfather, mm-hmm. somebody, distant relative, who is kind of this rich guy who lives in this very large estate, and he tires of conventional extravagance like, you mm-hmm. know, women and drinks and Hearthstone. And so he instead decides to pursue just the darkness and kind of the Lovecraftian horror. So he starts digging like crazy under his estate. And then he eventually uncovers like the kind of Cthulhu Yogg death mythology figure.
Yeah.
It just unleashes hell. So not just on the estate, but the whole surrounding area is just completely devastated. And he writes to you pleading before he takes his own life to come and redeem the family by conquering
the darkest dungeon.
So that's it. So we're here in the darkest dungeon, and we'll back out to the town here in a bit.
Yeah,
I'm not sure where you are.
At this point, I'm just trying to keep this. Honestly, if my Crusader doesn't die from like physical damage, he's dangerously close to having a heart attack and dying.
Right.
So like, I'm just trying to prevent that from happening yet. Any way that I can.
Sir Meow G asks, review coming soon for this game.
So Dan Stapleton, our reviews editor, our executive reviews editor, has been working hard on this review for sure. And of course, you dodged. Has been working hard on this review. Guys, it's a pretty hard game, and there's a lot of content to get through if you want to see and do everything. So, yeah.
No,
And he wants to give as comprehensive a review as possible because this game deserves it. Mm. But
yeah, and it's also a very different game in the first 2 hours than it ends up being 30 hours.
Heck yeah, it does. I mean, like, I think you and I both agree that when we up there he goes, we know we kind of knew that was gonna happen.
I think you may just have to retreat. Well, no, you could probably finish this battle, but I think after that.
Here's the thing: I kind of sometimes I don't know how much you've played the veteran level stuff, but a lot of times your retreat fails and you just end up taking lots of sanity damage. So I'm trying to
finish this dungeon and then retreat.
Yeah. I'm just trying to finish this. Maybe just finish this fight. Because if I try to retreat, it might just say, no, you can't. I lose the turn and probably take more damage. And I want that to happen. How much longer do I have this?
Yeah, you got to take out that stress lady.
Yeah.
Lady who stresses you out. I have not used solo yet.
Yeah, I only use it with... So I have this weird, wacky build that I do with this particular jester because I like the combination of solo and finale. You know, I actually start him at the front, and he has the highest speed, so he almost always rolls initiative above everyone else, and then I can just...
So the reason I don't take solo is because the finale debuffs you for a couple of turns, so then I just like to use his move forward one ability, which I believe is just called... it's like...
Yeah, Duelist's Advance or something?
No, it's called, like, something Dirk.
Or Dirk Stab. Dirk Stab.
And, and basically that gives him a little bit of time to recover, because otherwise he'll just do a lot reduced damage with the finale.
Yeah, but so my whole thing is, like, from the back row, the only thing he does is songs. So my whole rotation with him is finale to hopefully one-shot or heavily damage someone, and then have him sing songs from the back until that buff goes away, and then he solos up to the front again. And rinse, wash, repeat. That's kind of like how I do it, but it's being challenging. I'm not in a position with her right now to do any damage, which sucks because I need to do some damage. Okay, well, whatever. I'll just heal everybody. This is not optimal. There's nothing optimal about this.
I'm pretty confident you can walk away from this fight.
Oh, I will be able to, unless some massive unexpected crit comes along and totally screws everything up, I should be able to come through this, but it's still kind of annoying. In any case.
So, we have a couple of questions. If you have any questions, go ahead and type them in YouTube, Twitch, or Twitter. Tweet at IGN with a hashtag, IGN Plays Live. We have a question here from where to go. It's gone. I don't know who you were, but he asked, is this in beta? No, it's actually, this is the final release build. Yep.
Just finally came out last week, the beginning of this week.
It's been in beta. For a very long time.
Yes.
And this is the first time that we're able to see the Darkest Dungeon, which is the level 6 kind of final climactic dungeon.
Right. I'm curious. That's not what we're doing right now, but,
no,
but yeah.
I'm curious to see where this game goes in terms of community created content and custom levels and things like that, campaigns. And I'm curious to see that.
Yeah, that I think that cultist is killing me.
I think you may have a debuff on your accuracy or something.
You can probably. I don't know if I do. No, I don't. Her dodge is just really. So at level 3, once you go to level 3 stuff, everyone's. Like all the stats of these guys go way up. Like her dodge is not naturally 21. Like when you face off against her in a normal dungeon. Like her dodge is maybe like a 7 or something.
Right. So to be fair, your accuracy has gone up too on the characters that have it. There can be no hope in this hell. No, it's very. I mean, I guess you weren't relying on having 3 people, but just having finale is the only damaging thing on your jester. I think is hurting you right now.
Yeah. In this. Yeah. That's the thing is that this setup has worked very well for me when I don't get pushed out of like where I need to be. But like when I get pushed out of where I need to be, it totally kind of screws me. What's the chance of... Okay, so that's the minimum. So if it hits her, it's going to kill her. That's 5 straight attacks that have not hit her. She's got 21 dodge, granted.
Judgment.
But that shouldn't...
Do you have judgment on her?
Yeah, I do have judgment.
Oof, wow.
This is 6 straight dodges. That's kind of...
It's a lot. Now you're...
This might fall apart, to be honest.
Your Vestal is... There you go.
Okay, finally.
All right. This guy's not too much of a. I mean, that guy's on death's door. So.
Right. The problem is that this guy is very tanky, and what's happened. See, now again, this is another thing. Where
and he's
like,
undead, so you can't bleed him.
Yeah, I can't bleed him.
You have no blight.
Yeah, and he's got 45.
Just go for it. I would just let's get through this fight.
Yeah, that's all I can do, really.
Just start spamming attacks. Okay. Noah Simpson asks, "What is this game called?" It's Darkest Dungeon. Check it out on Steam. Does this game have a story? Asks Edson. Adrian. Aperia. Yes, it does. It's not necessarily light.
I'm gonna
story.
Try to run. There now that go. I have the, now that I have the, number, the numbers advantage, I'm just gonna run. The battle may yet be won.
Oh, you still have Dismas.
Yep.
Nice. Get out of the.
Yeah, I'm gonna abandon this quest.
Okay.
Everyone's gonna be
so miserable. Let's see what your town looks like. And what's cool about this game is it's not necessarily like save everyone. Sometimes you gotta let people go. Sometimes you gotta let people die.
Death is part of like they at the beginning of the game like or I love they have this splash screen at the beginning that they say like, look, you know this game's about making the best out of bad situations.
Yep.
Oof. Bad stuff for everybody. Woohoo! Yay! Look how fun this game is, guys. No, the game's actually a lot of fun.
They decrease the cost of this chance insane. For those kind of things it's to happen.
Yeah, I can tell. I can see quite clearly that they did that. Anyway, so yeah, here we are at my estate.
Oh, looks like you're pretty far along in terms of developing it.
Yeah. You can see I have quite a bevy of veterans of level threes, but you need to get they say that they suggest that you have a full party of level sixes. Of four level sixes to do even one of the darkest dungeons. There's four of them. And after you complete one, that team of level sixes is like, you know what? We've seen enough nonsense in our lives. And
really? They just leave?
Yeah.
Wow. Really?
So you actually need a minimum of 16 sixes to have a good chance of finishing the game. And yeah, it's no joke. All right. So these guys, they're blinking. So they've got afflictions of, they've got afflictions of some kind right now. He's irrational.
He looks. So we're gonna. That's interesting. It seems as though maybe this isn't the most optimal strategy, but I definitely like trying to get some negative quirks off people that affect their combat.
Oh, absolutely. That's always the priority, and I kind of let everything else more or less slide.
But it looks with Dismas that you've like just been like, fuck.
Well, I gotta admit, like he's kind of. He fell out of favor with me for a while. Like I wasn't really using him very much. Mm. That's right. She can only stress heal by flagellation.
Scruffy McDoodle asks, "What are the developers of this game?"
Red Hook.
Red Hook.
Yep.
It started on Kickstarter.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Very successful. This, along with FTL, I think, are probably the Tim Schafer game.
Yes, Broken Age.
Yeah. I think those are probably the most successful Kickstarter games.
Definitely way up there.
I may be missing some.
All right, so let's see what we want to do for this next round. I'm not actually going to jump right in. I like to see what I want to do, and then I form a team, and then I kind of go back. Because like, once I know what my team is, I like to maybe spend other people's off weeks taking care of some of their problems and whatnot. So Montague is actually getting up there in terms of his sanity right now.
He can go to level four without being like, I'm not doing any more level three missions, correct? I think the hard point. So basically, one thing that irks a lot of people when they start playing this game, they don't really understand it, is you get these heroes, they start at level zero. You can bring them to level one and two. That increases their stats as well as their resistance to stress, which is very important.
Yeah.
Going with all level zeros is totally different than going with all level twos in a novice dungeon. But when they hit level three, the heroes will refuse to do level two and lower dungeons. So basically, they think they're too good for it, and that can kind of create this divide in your team. There's definitely an awkward part where if not everybody levels up at once, you definitely have to mix up the teams that you would normally be bringing together. But I think what that incentivizes is not having an A team, a B team, a C team. Having these teams that you can build on the fly.
No, I actually really like that about this game, is that like it doesn't let you go on autopilot. Like it does not let you just be like, well, I'm just gonna take like a super easy way out build that I know works consistently in this situation, and you actually have to think about what you're doing, which I appreciate. You know what?
I'm gonna get a little bit nutty here. Hampton Bishop asks, this game is coming to PS4, correct? Any advice for new players? Yeah, it is coming to PS4. I would say advice for new players is don't be afraid to lose
characters. Yeah,
you can always restart. Characters. And also, your hamlet here, your village, is persistent. So you can have things go terribly, terribly wrong. I guess my advice would be avoid spending a lot of gold. If somebody gets, let's say, like your favorite character, who's the Crusader or something, gets -5 accuracy or something, and it's really detrimental to him in combat, but it's locked in, don't spend 6,000 gold fixing that, I think. Unless you really, really, really want to, or you have saved for it, because if you are at 10,000 gold and you spend 6,000 getting rid of a negative perk that's locked in, you're in a situation where you could... I've never really done that. Like, completely failed out in terms of, like, I just don't have enough money to provision.
Right. Or,
I've never done that, so I'm not sure.
Yeah, neither have I. But you can certainly start to run out of money and run into money problems if you don't manage things properly. I just want to see if anyone's got, like, a really, really bad, like... something that I just want to take care of. Actually, I'm kind of low on money, so I'm like, minus two speed is torches below 26. It's like just below 26. So reflexes isn't very good. I don't know. You know what? I don't feel like going through all this. We're just going to play.
Yeah.
We're just going to jump in.
Let's do some stuff.
So I'm going to do a lower level thing here because I'm actually trying to bring up these folks down here. Mm-hmm. Some of these folks up. And I just got a new plague doctor. I've never actually ran a plague doctor before.
They're great.
Yeah, they are pretty great.
I've
run them in I ran them in beta, but since release I haven't.
So something that's new with the release build is the Houndmaster would bring a biscuit.
Yep.
For his dog. People really like that. So now the Grave Robber will bring a shovel.
Yep.
The Witch Doctor will bring a blight cure potion, and actually it's made the game a lot easier in terms of provision.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
Saves you some gold for sure. Oops. Ooh, you like yourself some torches.
Well, this is a medium, so.
I know, usually, that's still a lot for medium.
It depends on where you go. Like, probably in the ruins it's a lot, but actually in the wield, like, things run out very quickly.
Oh, really?
I mean, I could probably get away with just 8
or 12. I think the biggest difference in gameplay for me from beta to live is I've been trying to play at lower light levels because the rewards are much, much better. So, having less light isn't necessarily a bad thing. It's much more dangerous. It's a much it's a riskier way to play. Mm-hmm. However, the rewards are greater. Your crit chance is higher, things like that. So
yeah, no, there's definitely pros and cons. Like when I feel like what I'll often do with a dungeon is that I will start out just doing my thing, and kind of staying at generally high-ish light, and then once I feel like I've just got it in the bag.
Sure.
Then I'll just be like, okay, like now I'll.
So there's a little. Oh, there you go. Trying to entryway towards that trap. Yeah. It's funny. I always pick like the agility archetypes as well. I'm not sure if that actually has. I know there are items that give a benefit to that.
No, different characters definitely have a different
default. Okay.
Yeah, different characters definitely have a different preset.
All right. Chance. Let's. What is the objective? Taylor Carly asks, what is the objective of the game or history? So the history is your family estate, thanks to your uncle's crazed digging, has become possessed with demons and undead and all kinds of nasty stuff.
Yep.
And you were trying to cleanse it.
A blazing star is born.
How much does the game cost? Is it 20?
Yeah.
20. I've sunk a lot of hours in this game, so it's,
me too.
It's pretty worth it.
Oh my god, he resists that blight. That's so stupid.
So one thing that, and this is a little bit, they do a pretty good job explaining what does what in terms of the text, but one thing that I've noticed isn't super consistent is, or they just don't really tell you, just kind of have to figure it out by using it, is any kind of dot, like a bleed or a blight,
uh-huh.
How many rounds it lasts. That information isn't really displayed anywhere.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Where?
Yeah, so I'll show you when I get to that, to exactly
is
that.
Is it? Interesting.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, it shows how much damage per turn it does and for how many rounds.
Oh, wow. Okay, yeah. I didn't see that.
Yeez.
I was trying to look.
Grave nibble. Oh, it's just a little nibble.
A little nibble that crit you for 5.
You just...
and stunned you.
What spiders do. Okay, so, yeah, let me show you. So, yeah, at the bottom, so Blight, 100% base, 3 points
oh, yeah.
for 3 rounds.
The heck? I feel like that's really weird.
Yep.
Oh, yep, maybe it doesn't... I feel like it doesn't show you out of the dungeon, maybe. I don't know. I was trying to look for it. So what I think is interesting about this game, I read a comment in here like, oh, this game is so unbalanced. I had that impression when I first started playing it, and then once you just really have to dive into each of these classes with the expectation that they are going to do, just try them out.
Yeah.
Try them out. Mm-hmm. The Occultist originally I thought was like oh, I'm never going to use this guy. His heals are totally inconsistent,
Cultist is probably my most consistently used class, I'd say.
He's very good. Yeah. So he is. He can mark targets, he can clear corpses, he can pull people, he can heal, he can damage. He's very versatile.
Yep.
The class that I probably use the least, just because it's so difficult to find a composition that will work with him, or even just go with him, is the Abomination. Which is the most recently.
Yeah, I haven't messed with the Abomination too much because
I've tried. He's really cool. He himself is super powerful, but he stresses
everybody out. Yeah. We surprised you,
fools.
Surprised you, fools. Yeah. Oh, that's right. I can blight undead. That's the nice thing about blight, is that it's a dot that works on undead.
Yeah.
Which is good.
Dots are super strong in this game.
They're very good. So, tank your enemies like that tank in the front has high protection value,
right,
which reduces incoming damage. So, and you can just like cut through him conventionally, but putting dots on him is great. But he's undead, so he can't be can't have bleed effects on him.
Right, correct. And you know, the nice thing, the main thing is that, like I said, the bleed damage or the blight damage completely ignores protection, so there is no. So yeah, you'll see enemies that have like not a lot of hit points but have very high protection stat, and that's just like you just dot them and forget about them and they just die in a turn, and it's really strong.
Like, all right, let's check this chat out. Again, you can tweet it as @IGN with hashtag IGN please, and I will read your tweet in my trailer voice. Nightwing84 says, "Just got back from school."
Ugh, sorry.
It's
the worst.
A powerful blow.
MangoGaming44 says, "This is like a copy of Dark Souls 2, in my opinion." I disagree. It's completely different. However,
that's interesting.
Aesthetically, similar. I think they're both. This is almost kind of like the Dark Souls RPG in a sense, or turn-based RPG.
Sure.
It's absolutely its own universe and aesthetic and stuff like that. However, they both do feel very oppressive in ways that other games don't.
Yeah, sure. They have that going for them. That's similar in the sense that they both kind of aim to make you feel helpless and kind of like you're. Again, like I think that intro piece in this game does such a good job of it. It says it's about making the best of a bad situation.
Yeah. Even just that intro cinematic. It absolutely. Mesmerized me when
oh,
I
me
first
too.
Started the game. I was just immediately engrossed into the world, which is very cool. So the actual, we have a question here from, what is your name? Christopher Underwood asks, when is the release date? The official release date was the 19th of January. So it is already released. It has been released for about 3 days, and it has been in early access for who knows how long? A year, more?
Yeah, over a year. Yeah.
A long time.
It was this time last year that I remember that like the office was buzzing about this game, and we were all like, oh my god, this game's going to be so good.
Yeah, I think there was a pretty, there was like kind of a consensus that I don't want to play this until it's in its finality.
Yeah.
And I absolutely shared that sentiment because when I started, I was like, this is really cool, but a lot of people are saying it falls off towards the higher levels because they aren't developed yet.
Right.
So I'm just going to wait. And I've now kind of started my playthrough. And what's interesting about this game is sometimes, like, you know, when I play Dark Souls for too long, I get a little bit, I'm like, eh, I'm not going to play this for, like, a couple hours.
Right, right.
But with this, I just do this all night.
Oh, yeah. It's it totally, totally sucks you in. Like, I've... this is, like, the only game that could possibly pull me away from this year, I think, like, for any extended period of time, is going to be, well, Street Fighter V, because I'm a huge...
Right.
Because, you know, I'm a big fighting game guy. But other than that, would just be XCOM 2.
Yeah, that's going to be very exciting.
Super excited for XCOM.
Tobias Sandstorm asks, what about multiplayer? There is no multiplayer in this game. Not that kind of game.
Nope.
Which is fine. I'm not sure how multiplayer would work. I remember while we're on the subject of Kickstarter successes in multiplayer, I remember when I first played FTL, I was like,
Oh, I didn't bring another shovel with me. That's what I forgot to bring.
These suck.
Yeah.
Tools of iron. I feel like they used to be way worse, though.
They were way worse.
So they used to... Okay, maybe it's not just my imagination.
Yeah, no, they were way worse. They did a lot more damage to you. They did a lot more sanity damage. They were horrible.
Remember when I played FTL for the first time? I was like, man, if each one of these people on the ship were an actual person and there was like some metagame to controlling each part of the ship, it would be really awesome. But I'm not sure how you do multiplayer with this besides, I mean, this is just like, there's plenty of games where you play as the individual character here in a dungeon. Mango Gaming 44 asks, are you guys going to play Dark Souls 3? Absolutely.
Absolutely. For sure.
Totally. I'm sure Chloe is very excited about that.
Oh, yeah. Right now, the game she's reviewing right now is really doing a number on her head, and she's really into it. She's playing that The Witness.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So,
I got pulled into a meeting the other day. It was like a witness meeting, and they were just telling me how great it was and how they want to do Let's Plays of it.
Yep.
I'm like, that's great, and I'm really excited you're happy, but that probably could have been summarized in an email. It was like, we just love it so much. I'm like, yeah, it's really cool. So we're going to do some Let's Plays for that.
No, but you're right. That's like, but isn't that the whole thing? Like that is the plight of the modern.
That's true.
Any office, right? This meeting could have been an email.
I'm really happy my whole day is with meetings. There are plenty of places to work where it's just all meetings and you get nothing.
Yeah, this is. I'll be the first person to say, you guys. By the way, if you're watching, like, do not take what I'm doing right now as any kind of like optimal. This was a thrown. I said what below level threes do I have, and I threw them in a team. There's nothing synergistic about what I'm doing here. This is really just this is really just me just screwing around.
We have a question from Chris Underwood asks, when is the PS4 version releasing? I'm not sure
think
that
we have solid
it.
Yeah. I
However, I interviewed the developer who was showing off at PS Now or PSX.
Uh-huh.
He was showing off the PS4 version of the game, and I think he said Q1? Don't quote me on that, but I feel like he said Q1 2016. So,
what I need is I need this game on the Vita. I need it in my life.
Yeah. Yeah, this would be really good. This and FTL, man. I just wish I could play FTL on my phone. Because I have the iPhone 6 Plus, so it's real, real huge. You can play it on the iPad, but I'm just not going to carry an iPad with me for the sake of playing FTL.
FTL is pretty special, though.
It's a great game.
I feel like this one of the lessons this game teaches you is that reading is for suckers. Like every once in a while, you'll read a book, a stack of books, or one of those things, and every once in a while, it'll be actually something like not bad for you. But 9 times out of 10,
literally every time I've gone inside an Iron Maiden, the person's just got stuck in there.
Yeah, yeah.
Gotten claustrophobia, which I was trying to figure out what claustrophobia does. Even with wikis, some of the negative quirks you can get are still a little bit vague.
Yep.
And claustrophobia, as far as I can tell, just forces. They just want to go back in. They just go right back in to the Iron Maidens, which is the exact opposite
of what claustrophobia is.
Reading is for suckers. BFG Gaming says, best quote ever, reading is for suckers.
That's what the game teaches you. It's like, nope, you should never read. Never read, kids.
Never read. If you want to start reading and books are just way too much for you, watch Narcos on Netflix because the entire film or the entire series is subtitled, but it's great. I remember when I started watching that, I got done with the first episode. I was like, that was great. That was a lot of reading. I'm going to play video games now.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with reading. But
sure. But it is for suckers. Let it
right.
Be
yeah. I mean, you can totally read.
If you're a nerd. Daniel Dare says, no shoutouts.
No shoutouts?
Isn't that ironic that I just shouted out your no shoutouts?
I was just going to say, what does he mean? Does that mean like we're not supposed to? He doesn't want us to give shout-outs?
No, I think he may have asked for a shout-out.
Oh, okay.
I'm shouting you out now, bro. Somebody says, is this worth $30? Is it $30? Did I pay like a... No, it's $19. You can buy the collector's edition, which comes with the soundtrack, which, spoilers, you hear in the game anyway. So I'm very torn when it comes to collector's edition editions, because on the one hand, if there's some kind of like aesthetic bonus that I have now missed out on, it infuriates me. But then on the other hand, if it's just like a soundtrack and a wallpaper, I'm not going to buy it.
Right, yeah.
So I mean, I'm a huge hypocrite when it comes to that.
It's not. You're not a hypocrite, dude. Like, you know what it comes down to? It's like value is different for everybody. Like, what's value for you is not value for me, and vice versa and stuff. You know, like it's. Don't let anyone tell you what, like, you know. Oh, you're wasting your money. You know, like.
Right.
If it's money you had to spend and you get stuff that you liked, then it's not a waste.
I've gone to eBay a couple times and bought some old collector's editions. I remember the first time
that's
I did that.
That's such a waste of money, dude.
The first time I did that was Warhammer Online. I started playing it, and I was playing as an orc or a greenskin, and I saw another greenskin, and he had like a plate over half of his face. I was like, oh, how do you get that face? It was just his face. He was level one. He was like collector's edition. I was like, oh. Then I went and spent like $60 on it or something after I had already purchased the game. I've done that with way higher like League of Legends skins and World of Warcraft stuff. The flag of flag of ownership in World of Warcraft. You, when you gank somebody, you can plant a flag on their corpse that has the thumbs down. As soon as I saw that, I was like, I need it.
I need that in my life.
I need it.
That is such a James Duggan thing.
Maybe the best $40 I've ever spent. Yeah, because I felt so terrible that somebody did that to me. I was like, who would ever do it? How would you think you're great, huh? And then I was like, man, like, I can make everybody feel that for the low, low price of $40 for a World of Warcraft item.
I think I'm going to make camp here. I'm actually not doing that great right now. But I very brazenly decided to like not take a healer with me because I'm like, it'll be fine.
Sometimes you can. You can definitely get away with it. Yeah, camping's good.
Yeah, I'm gonna we're gonna have a full feast.
Yum yum yum. How much food do you have left?
Should have plenty.
Four. Sweet, you can get one more. The thing that I never take enough of on the medium and long trips is food. It seems like they just get super hungry sometimes.
Yeah, there's some that actually
I'm gonna take my shirt off.
Good. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Look at that luxuriant bungee shirt he's got on underneath that other shirt. Man, that's some shirt. God, do I have anything? It's so funny if I don't have anything that heals either. I didn't pay any attention.
Oh, man. What's going on with this cord? How do they work?
The leeches shall purify your blood.
All right.
Oh, Battle Trance is really good.
Let's read some stuff.
There really isn't a lot of healing for me to do here.
Daniel Dare says, I spent $80 on a FF4 for SNES. That was a long time ago. I assume that's Final Fantasy IV? I've never been a big Final Fantasy guy.
Yeah, I would say that's what that is. Man,
camping is so fun.
Oh yeah, I love camping.
Camping is so great in this game, though I've never upgraded anybody's camping skills. I don't care.
Yeah, because you don't actually upgrade the skills themselves. What you do is you unlock more of their more of their skills.
That's like a variable I'm totally fine with them not having.
Yeah,
camping is one of those. Yeah, it's a very interesting part of this game. So basically what camping does is people have their default abilities, which are like combat. They have passive quirks and things like that. And then they have camping skills, which when you camp, like the leper can take his mask off, which really relaxes him but stresses everybody else.
Just everyone else out because he's a leper, right?
He's a leper, which actually, fun fact about leprosy, it's not that contagious.
Right.
Which is crazy. And it's just bacteria. Purchase. Man, I'm so happy we live in the age we live in. I would hate to have to worry about leprosy.
Because, man.
Even if you contracted leprosy now, you can just go to the doctor and he's like, oh, here
you go.
Antibiotics. You're fine.
You'll be fine.
Fun facts about leprosy. Tweet us all your leprosy-related factoids. at IGN.
How many leprosy? How many leprosy-related factoids could there realistically be?
I know a few. There was
Let's
the
hear
King
them.
Of Jerusalem.
Right. We were talking about
this. Had leprosy, and he was in the Kingdom of Heaven, but actually in reality, he was a real D-bag. He was not a nice guy.
Really?
Yeah.
I would never have guessed that.
Yeah, he just... His uncle, who was serving as king regent before him because he wasn't old enough, when his father died, made a truce agreement with Salah ad-Din, which ended like 12 years of war or something like that.
Uh-huh.
And then as soon as he got into power, he was like, nah, screw that. Get out of here, people who are different than us.
Get lost.
Yep. Great movie, Kingdom of Heaven. It's got to be one of my top historical Crusader flicks. Right up there with Outcast, starring Nicolas Cage and Hayden Christensen.
It's a pretty good one.
Man, Nick Cage.
He's a good
man. I've been catching up on my Nick Cage films.
Oh, yeah?
But there's just this certain...
You had gaps in your Nick Cage?
There's a certain time after National Treasure where everything he made is... hot garbage. But everything before that's pretty good. Like Gone in 60 Seconds, National Treasure.
Sure.
What else? The Rock. There's some good.
The Rock
good Nick
is,
Cage.
Is
I
not
like,
good. The Rock is great. The Rock is.
I thought you were going the other way with that because I was going to be like, yeah, it's not great. or not good.
The Rock is it's a special, special movie.
Vildi Glaret says, I met him once.
Who? The Rock?
No, Nick.
Come on, it was a little good. It was kind of
pretty
okay,
good.
I'm gonna go home now. I'm sorry.
Game Delay says, "How many historical Crusader flicks are there?" A few.
Right.
There's quite a few, actually. I feel like there's at least 10, if not. There's got to be. There's got to be in the history of film. There's got to be like 30.
I'm sure there's a lot more than the 10. This is the trap maker's art. I love this quote. His efficacy unwitnessed by his own eyes. I love this. I love the narrator of this game.
Yeah, he's great.
Efficacy unwitnessed by his own eyes.
One of my favorite things that he ever said is the cost of preparedness measured now in gold and later in blood.
In blood.
Good stuff.
So good. Okay, I'm going to purify this urn.
So that's what you use holy water for is purifying relics so you don't get diseases or curses from them.
And you usually get more, you usually get significantly more stuff out of them as well when you do that.
So I have a question for you.
Yeah, man.
Actually, never mind. I just answered my own question, but I'll ask it anyway for the sake
sure,
of people learning
it.
At home. The majority of the time that I use either holy water or the keys on chests or relics or stuff like that, and it says this item has no effect, that's a pretty good indicator that it's trapped, right? Though sometimes I have gotten stuff from them, but I find a lot, maybe I just have a small sample size, but I find a lot of the time, when I do that, and then I'm like, well, I'm going to open it anyway. It's just trapped.
It's pretty common. I can't disagree with you. I find that happens a lot, yeah. I don't know if it's 100%. I've never paid attention that much attention to it. I probably should.
Mango Gaming 44 asks, what is your favorite type of gaming console? The Dreamcast.
Dreamcast is a great system. That's one of my favorite systems.
That's it.
Of all time.
That's the end of that debate. For me, it's probably the N64. Although the original Xbox was fantabulous.
Oh, yeah.
And the PlayStation 2.
Yeah, Super Nintendo's very high on my list. Super Nintendo and Dreamcast are pretty much, for me, the creme de la creme.
My favorite console is my computer.
Look at me, I'm so cool.
There aren't too many of us PC Master Racers in the office, but I'm certainly one of them.
It's funny that we live in a world where, like, you say that with pride.
I do. I love it.
It's like someone being like, I'm so proud to be an Xbox fanboy. It's the best.
Well, I feel like it's a different sentiment if you're a console fanboy. But hey, I'm biased, so it's a different sentiment if you're proud of being a console peasant.
I'm not proud of anything. I just like playing games. That's my point. I'm just proud of playing. I like to play games. I like movies.
There's like maybe like three games that have not come to PC in the past 10 years that I've been like, dang, I wish I could play that.
That's all I like to do. I just want to play the games. I don't care if they're on the PCs. I don't care if they're on the consoles. I just want to play games. I like playing games.
Moonman asks, what's the hardest challenge you've ever faced in Darkest Dungeon? For me, it's the Collector. He's just really annoying, man. I didn't have the deeps to deal with his crap that he summoned. But yeah. They have nerfed him. Which is proof enough that he was not balanced properly.
When did they nerf him?
They nerfed him with release, so he can't just keep spawning heads. There's a set amount of heads he can spawn.
Oh, really?
Yeah, before, like, I would just kill all of the heads he spawned, which actually have pretty good... They have, like, 12 or 15 health for level 1, which is a lot. And he would just keep spawning them. And then he would get the Vestal spine, and it would just heal him. So it was just... I like the ooze. When the ooze duplicates, it feels appropriate because they're a little bit weaker... They don't do a lot of damage, yep. And it feels like a really cool mechanic. The Collector just felt kind of cheap. Man, you guys are hungry.
Yep. What the?
Oh, is this a secret room?
I've never been in the secret room.
Go ahead.
1,000 golden onyx.
It's exciting.
I've never... I'm going to be honest and say I don't know how I got there just now. I heard they added this secret room. I heard about that, but I've never been there.
Let's ask our viewers a question, which we ask them. What's the circumference of your bicep? Mine's at least 24 inches. I have no idea if that's accurate.
Look at you.
I have no idea. What is your favorite turn-based RPG of all time? For me, it might be Darkest Dungeon.
Darkest Dungeon is, I can't even lie.
Although XCOM's fantastic.
Way up there. XCOM is way up there if you want to consider it an RPG. I can see the argument for sure. I would not tell someone like, no, I can't.
It's not an RPG. There's light RPG elements in it.
You know? Well, it depends on, you know, how light those RPG elements are really depend on what mods you're playing with.
Hey, let's have an offshoot discussion, a sidebar, if you will, talking about kind of current realistic games, low fantasy games or low sci-fi games,
right?
Like XCOM,
sure,
or something like that, and RPG elements. Because I've been looking at Tom Clancy's The Division.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very excited for it. I'm very excited with some of the stuff that it's doing. However, my main deterrent from that game, and I've told Ben this to no end, is so it's got like this realistic combat feel, like 10 years in the future combat,
right?
So it's very realistically grounded in the aesthetic, but it has heavy RPG elements to the point where you can just unload into somebody's head with like an LMG for 30 seconds before they die.
Right.
Which those two things do not mix at all for me.
No,
they're like
they
water
don't.
And oil. They just don't.
And then there's
it doesn't work.
And then there's the element of the AI, which where like guys just kind of feel like they're just standing there in the open or
taking your
kind of running into your field of fire.
Sure.
And
that kind of thing works for Borderlands. It works for Destiny because
right.
those are removed enough that you'd be like, oh, he's a space alien. Of course, he's got like an overshield or
right.
like carbon fiber skin or something. Whatever. I can dig it.
This doesn't make sense for The Division, though.
No.
You know?
Not at all.
Doesn't.
Which is sad because I think that there's a lot of interesting things that game.
Oh, yeah.
Brought low and driven into the mud. A lot of people are super excited for that game. I am cautiously optimistic. I have not pre-ordered
it. I think that describes...
I don't think I will pre-order it. I think it's one of those games... I have two mindsets of a game. I get super hyped and I pre-order it 3 years before it comes out and then have completely forget about it until it comes out. Or I wait like a year or two. And that's kind of been my thing that I do with single-player narrative games.
Sure.
As long as I can avoid the spoilers is I just, you know, because then it's not like I'm late to the party because it's a
right.
single-player intimate experience. But
I don't know if you saw, but like there, I just bounced over that cultist, and her dodge was like 13. So you can see, like before, it was 21 in
right.
the other one. So right. all those numbers start to scale up in really, frankly, kind of obnoxious ways.
You're doing pretty well for not having a healer.
For having no healer, I think I'm doing fine. We'll see if I make it.
I really like the off healers, like the Arbalest and the Crusader, and actually, a lot of people. Are on the same page when it comes to the leper, that he's just the worst. I love... He may be my favorite class.
I love the leper.
I love his
heal. He hits like a truck. Like his starting damage is insane.
You got to put some accuracy items on him.
Yeah.
Or if you get quirks that give accuracy, then it's great because his starting accuracy sucks because he's
right
has leprosy. But there we go. Just coming back to leprosy.
Yeah,
just
man.
Take it away from him.
That's always what it's about in the end. It's always what it's about. Oh, that was the wrong move. I did the wrong thing. I did the wrong thing, folks. I'm bad at video games.
People are having discussions about different climate temperances in various regions of the world.
Interesting.
In the chat. Cool. I'm into it. It's in San Francisco, it's uncharacteristically rainy right now. Has been for past month or so. Although I guess it's a lot of people have said that we're obviously in a drought, so the years that I have been here, I guess it's not rained a lot, which is
sure.
Coming. All right, Twitch chat, I'm checking you out. Thanks for the whoa earlier. If I could get another one, that would that really help me out. If you guys just go ahead and like and subscribe, that would really help me out.
Hey guys, thanks guys. I'm trying to think if I should get rid of.
Let's scroll up. I'm gonna scroll up a bit, and I'm gonna read the Twitch chat in its entirety.
From the top.
Game Delay agrees with you, saying, "Sweet Lord above, I wish this game were on my Vita already."
Yeah, I'd be cracking out on this game every day on the train if it was.
He reiterates, "Seriously, want this on my Vita."
Like seriously.
Seriously.
So seriously, guys. I have no idea just how serious it is.
BFG Gaming, I think when we were talking about the class balance thing, every class in this game is good. It's neat to build all sorts of different groups based on different skill builds. I agree. Ran a group last night with one Houndmaster and three Abominations. So much fun.
Oh, wow. That sounds fun.
I can't
fun.
Believe I haven't thought to put three Abominations, like, just have a group of four Abominations.
That sounds like a lot of fun.
One of my favorite, and again, Gravedigger and Jester were not really classes that I thought were that great, but I really love their mobility and how they just jump back and forth between combat. That's super fun.
Jester, that Jester that I had before, Montague, that is my most used character. He's ran more missions for me and been in more missions for me than any other of the characters.
Do you name your characters?
No.
I do.
The
naming algorithm in this game is a little not great. I've gotten one time I had three characters named Lucy on my roster, two of which were Houndmasters, which are men. So I was like, this naming algorithm. So I just, you know, basically if they complete a mission and I like them and they haven't gotten some terrible negative quirk, I name them. kind of that mindset, like when you would only name a child when he reaches 3 years old.
Right, so, right, right.
His mortality rate was so high.
I'm just gonna let this guy die from poison for fun.
Haha.
talking about our favorite turn-based RPG, can we throw out Valkyria Chronicles?
Absolutely.
Does that count as an RPG?
Yep, that's a big thumbs up from me and from super producer Ben Janka, who totally agrees with you.
And Jenga likes two things, Valkyria Chronicles and Solid Snake.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
Moonman asks, I keep seeing an aura around the heads of players. What does that mean? So that indicates that their stress is being reduced.
Yes, that little halo-ish light thingy.
When you see kind of the barbed red and black halo, that means that they're... Yeah, there you go. I think you gotta drag it. You gotta shift click it.
Oh, usually I can just replace it.
Oh, really? That halo, the like negative halo means they're being stressed, basically.
Okay, well this is interesting. Oh, there is one more room. Okay. I was gonna say I don't think I saw.
Chaparito 123456 says, "I love you guys so much. I was in such a horrible mood, and then I joined the stream, and you made my day." Man,
did I never go to... I'm sorry. I hate to interrupt. Did I never go to this room? Was I right there and I never went?
Yeah. I'm sorry you're so bad. But
I'm sorry,
too. The good news is when you backtrack in this game, it's much easier than going forward. Although stuff does randomly pop up. Chaparito, thanks so much for joining us. We're happy we had a positive impact on your life. All right. Coming back to YouTube. What we got?
hunger. Oh no, we don't have enough food for the to deal with the hunger.
Such a little thing, a bite of bread.
That is the first time I've ever had been hit with adverse effects from hunger.
Kyle O'Connor says, "I bet Vince can't even beat me in Mortal Kombat."
That is not true.
He didn't even say that. I made that up.
Sounded like something you more like something you would say. Now that said, Kyle O'Connor has beaten me in Mortal Kombat.
Sure.
It is not a thing that's never happened.
Set the stage for heroism or cowardice.
I'm just super excited about Street Fighter V. Like, I'm so ready for that game to be out. I was watching the Mad Catz Cup the last couple of nights, which is right at the Folsom Street Foundry right here in San Francisco.
Folsom Street Foundry is the spot.
Oh, it's so good.
They've had Hearthstone unveilings there. They've had Hearthstone professional events there. You can just go any, I believe it's Tuesday or Thursday, and if you're over 21, you just go to the bar, you play some games. They have all kinds. They have Nidhogg. They have all manner of competitive games. They have that one on Steam that's like kind of a Super Smash Bros. For PC
deal. And board games?
They have board games. Although, like, I will say, for board games, I prefer a quieter setting.
Oh, sure.
Like when you're playing The Resistance, you have to scream your face off.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Hunger again? We literally just...
I feel like Hunger is based on distance traveled.
Yeah, but like literally just a couple of...
I know, man.
Of rooms ago, we got it.
He didn't eat. He had a little hissy fit, and now he wants to. Now he's a masochist and will refuse healing. Miriam and Hizelin says, "Give me a shout out, please. Shout out complete."
To think this room was just here before, and I just didn't come here. Maybe.
A holy rally.
I could have avoided all of this nonsense.
Man, they don't stack.
No, they don't stack.
Oh, that's a real bummer. You could equip somebody with that cloak.
Yeah, it's fine. I'm not going to worry about a couple of...
Oh, yeah, you're done.
Couple of torches. We did
it! That was our first... Those holy relic ones are...
They're long.
They're a chore.
Yeah, they go in. So let's see... this is an okay payoff.
That's for the leper, right? That wrist thing? Or is that for the Houndmaster? The thing, the quest reward wrist. Oh, no, it's just for whoever. The leper tends to have a lot of bracer activity going on.
Cool. So this is like a decent... So I took like... So this is 13K altogether with the quest reward and the treasure I found. It's not bad.
Would you describe this as a roguelike?
Sure. Yeah, I would.
I have no problem. A lot of people have a problem with that term. I don't.
Yeah, no, I don't have a problem with that term.
I think it's just a distinction. I was watching... Not to start beef with anybody, but I was watching a Total Biscuit video about terms that should be stricken from the gaming.
Oh,
yay.
And it's just like roguelike. It's an adjective. It's a describing word. It's how you differentiate I'm hungry from I'm starving.
I will say that as
easy. No, okay. I thought you were going to go on. No. You just had a look in your eye.
Oh no! I'm just gonna say, like, as a writer, as a person who writes professionally, one of the things that bothers me the most, and professional writers do it almost more than anybody else, is decide that certain words are just worthless, and they need to be stricken from the language.
I think how
pompous, and I'm not calling anyone. I didn't watch this Total Biscuit thing, so I'm not.
Sure.
I don't have any problem with Total Biscuit. But this is something that I see a lot in the critical circle of video games.
Mm-hmm.
And it bugs me. I'm just like, look, if you have a problem with the way some people use a word, that's understandable. If you feel that some people overuse that word, understandable.
Right. And I can totally agree with that.
But like, at the end of the day, you don't get to say, well, this word is just useless. Every word has use. Every word in our language has a use.
Even insert crazy word here.
Right. So I always think it's very silly and very honestly quite pompous to be like, well, that word.
I think there are certainly cliche terms. And the one that definitely bothers me, if I were going to make a list like that, if I were forced to make a list like that, would be emergent.
I don't think there's anything wrong with that word.
No, there's nothing
it's
wrong
a word
with
that,
that word.
Describes a certain
it
thing.
Is certainly overused though. And I do think that the definition, for me, it's more of a problem of semantics where, like, to me, emergent is not randomly scripted events. It's something that happens organically.
Oh, right, of course, yeah.
I think the point of the video was more to, like, kind of argue the semantics of, hey, I think we're using this word a little bit incorrectly or whatever, but...
And that's right, like, we should always have checks on that. We should always be paying attention, like, and being vigilant about, you know, not misusing words or not not allowing, like... I mean, even saying to misuse words is kind of like a little bit of a weird territory to me, because, you know, I definitely believe that language is fluid and that it changes over time, and that many of the words we use today, every day, had a different meaning at some point, and then at another point, through common usage and current events of the day, people's ways of using those words changed, and over time it became accepted, and now today that's the way we use those words. And it's funny because, like, even though that's there's hundreds of documented cases of that happening over the course of recorded history, we still, when as older people especially, when we hear someone using a word in a way that we feel is wrong, right, we're like, no, no, it's not allowed to mean that. You can't say that there. And it's like, well, yeah, I mean... This is something to be said for protecting the meaning of language, but there's also something to be said for the fact that you just can't change the fact that it changes over time. I don't know.
Like the term on fleek.
A term that I'm convinced is like a social troll.
Well, your eyebrows are on fleek, for sure.
I don't know about that. I don't do anything to my eyebrows.
They're on fleek?
They're just naturally on fleek.
Naturally on fleek.
There's naturally, I don't know, man. You see how I was just born with it?
All right, so now that everybody's level 3, you're almost everybody. What's our next step?
My next step is I want to get rid of this. I hate diseases. Diseases make me so mad. This game. Because, like, weak enemies will just randomly be like, "Heh, you only took 2 points, but here's this permanent disease that you're going to have to spend 1,000 gold to get rid of later." And I'm like, "I hate you.
I hate you."
All right.
I really like this guy's comment.
What's that?
It has no bearing on anything, but I kind of want to read it because it's in all caps.
Go for it.
Which is not... No, that's... I'm setting a poor example. Everybody else is going to type in all caps. Whatever, I'll do it. I'm not going to say his name because this is not something I want to see recreated in the chat. However, I am MLG Cool Kid. Get no scoped. Damn, son, where you did you find this MLG Sandstorm and get no cooped? He forgot the S on that last scoped, but it's...
No cooped.
It made me laugh.
No,
I'm sorry, I'm a simpleton.
He got no cooped. That's pretty awesome. The Warrens are where the pigs are, right? The Warrens are where the pigs are.
And then he immediately, then as soon as I, right before I said that, he said, "Shut up and talk about something else." We did. We talked about your dumb comments. There you go.
All right. So we're going to go into the Warrens, I think. We're gonna kill us some piggies. So who do I want to bring into the Warrens?
Brandon Graber says, "Can we strike cinematic universe from the books while we're at it?"
No, we can't strike anything. That's not how language works. You don't get to just strike things that you think are dumb or not worth using to you from the lexicon. That is not how it works, Brandon Graber, and you know that.
Extended universe is a pretty dumb term. I'm not saying we need to strike it. I just basically saying, like, this is all the ghetto fiction that writers will trample on in a heartbeat. But I'm glad you spent 12 hours reading our book. We're just going to strike it from the canon, though. So, Star Wars.
You sound wounded.
Hey, man.
You sound like a wounded man.
How can you strike Kyle Katarn from the canon and keep...
Here we go.
And keep the prequels.
Here we go.
If they retconned everything, including the prequels, I would be like, sure. You know, we got rid of some good, but we got rid of a lot of bad. Instead, they just got rid of a lot of good. Whatever. It's a kid's... The movies are for kids.
Right? You're so mad.
That's always the out when somebody gets too hyphy about Star Wars. It's like, relax, dude. The movies are for kids. And you're a child for getting upset over it.
See, here's the problem I'm running into now is that I want to do a level 3 for everybody, but I don't have a reasonable frontline level 3 character, which is why I was trying to level other people up. Now, you can take someone who's not of the appropriate level into they're just going to go... Their sanity resistance is going to be so low, and they're just going to go bonkers after after a few fights. Mm-hmm. So I'm like,
Have you ever done that? Have you ever taken people who...
Oh, yeah, you can do
you're
it.
Just not really that keen on resuscitating and...
Oh, you're right. Thank you. Yeah, let me just find some schleb from the stagecoach. Yeah, there you go.
Bam.
Cool.
Yeah. Schleb.
Hi,
that sounds like a Rick and Morty word.
Hi, Ormond. Ormond, what are your skills?
How many schmeckles does he have?
Doesn't really matter. Doesn't really matter what your skills are.
Are you just gonna take a suicide party and just kill him?
Your skills are gonna include.
Who are you?
Have you figured this out?
What?
This.
Yeah, it's just it's completely static. As far as I know, there are no like hidden passive bonuses or something. It's just totally like flavorful.
I don't know. I feel like
there's sacred and profane. Because you have
no,
two holy men and you have an occultist there.
I understand, but like, there's got to be a reason that happens.
You know what I was surprised about is that you can't bring the abomination with the leper. Because apparently he's religious.
Oh, no?
No.
Okay. So this isn't going to really go well. I'm just going to let everyone know. This is probably going to be a disaster.
Trey Beckers asks, do you ever get tired of people commenting? I personally don't.
No, me neither.
I enjoy discussion, even if it takes a weird turn. Because, hey, I'm a weird dude.
I'm trying to remember. Do the piggies hand out a lot of blight?
Yeah.
Yeah, they do, right? So I should take some antivenoms.
What's really annoying, too, is they hand out a lot of diseases. There's, like, the vomiter who will just seize the crap out of all of your people.
Yep. You will have such disease just flowing through you. Freely.
Let the disease flow.
Let the disease
flow. Is that a short or is this a medium?
This is a short.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a short. So we'll see.
I like four torches for a short. I'm real stingy with my torches. I don't know why.
I mean, like, especially at a level 3, I'm not trying to play around. You know, war against the swine, we must first
scout their squalid homes. Yeah, I did get a whole party wiped last night, so. And it was like a party where I had a couple of people, like my main occultist got wiped. I was like,
oh, yeah. That's rough. That's rugged.
Why don't you want to stick your hand in the giant pile of corpses?
Oh, because it's probably a one-way ticket to Diseaseville. The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it. Yeah, this is a scouting one, so hopefully we'll be a little
bit... What's up for a trap? You get a poo pit for anyone.
I don't really have anyone to...
Who's going to go wade through the mire?
Oh, you know what? That? Oh, it'll probably go.
Just. You can go right. Oh, okay, there you go. Watch your
step. He's bleeding.
Trey Becker says it's his birthday. I don't believe you, but happy birthday.
God.
And then immediately after, which happened too quickly to be a non-coincidence, Frederick Arndt asks, "Does anyone want cake?" And then did a bunch of cake emojis.
I want cake.
What? Ooh, hey. These are two special enemies. We got an I've seen the
slavering
ghoul before.
I've seen the slavering ghoul. I've never seen this guy. So this is going to be fun, folks. So his resistances are all really high. So I'm not going to be definitely not blighting him. Probably not bleeding or stunning him consistently.
He doesn't have
this is going to be great.
He doesn't have a lot of prot. How much? He just has a lot of health.
Yeah, he has a lot of health.
Slice through him. Thankfully, you have a very experienced crusader.
Yep.
In position
No, he'll be able to handle this just fine.
So the occultist sacrificial dagger does bonus damage
to Eldritch. Yeah, I know.
Yeah. Yep. Although he's a beast, he's not even an Eldritch.
Yeah, he's not. So that's great. All right. Well, it's fine. This is fine. Everything's fine.
Yeah, I think
I really want to. I really want to get rid of this thing.
I think that's the right move.
It's terrifying me.
Got a lot of eyes.
It's like a 70% resistance to stun. It's not gonna.
Yeah. Although you can maybe stun the guy behind him.
Yeah.
Oh no, he's got 72. Whatever.
Yeah, nope.
Just go for it.
I'm just damage.
That's fine. 7's good. Game delay says,
11.
"Damn, the art in this game—they nailed the mood so well." I agree.
Yep, totally.
BFG Gaming. Oh, here we have a little bit of exposition about that group naming thing.
Uh-huh.
Oh man, he's already almost dead. Big guy.
Yeah, we're doing some damage.
BFG Gaming, do you know anything about the group caption, says Game Delay. BFG Gaming says, you mean the name groups? They're just specific names the dev put for certain layouts. He thinks it means they work well together. I don't know. I think that's kind of up to your discretion. Oh, man. You know what
What?
That corpse looks a lot like the Hound corpse from Hellboy, the Hound of Resurrection.
Oh, yeah.
Samael.
Right, yep.
So, I'd be really curious to see. I'm calling it right now. That corpse is going to come back to life. He was too easy to kill for such an awesome monster.
We'll see.
I've never seen a corpse do that, except for the oozes.
You've never seen, yeah, in all your experience dealing with real-life corpses.
Never seen a corpse.
You've never seen a corpse do that. That makes
not a single one.
Seems like a reasonable.
Especially one as strange looking as that.
I'm just going to take a hack at this corpse, I guess.
Do you have the poll? Eldritch poll?
On him, I might, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, Corpse Clear is the one of my... you can turn corpses off. I really like how clutch corpse clearing is.
Oh, yeah. It's big. And his bleed resistance is only 40. I might be able to...
bleed him?
I might be able to bleed him.
Yeah, I think putting any more damage into that corpse is a wasted
effort. Oh, no, I would never... I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't do that in this situation. He's already used his action... if I stun him.
Game Delay says, when is this coming to Vita? We don't know. Is it coming to Vita? I don't think there have been any. Potato King says, I think you should get Benjanka to on stream slowly unbutton his shirt again. That was pretty weird last time. Yeah,
sounds
it
hot.
Potato King's seen some streams. He's a vet.
Oh my god, I'm critting. I'm getting these heal crits right now.
Dude,
so clutch.
The occultist I lost never rolled zero. I think the lowest he ever rolled in all of his dungeons, which he had quite a few, he was level 3, was like a 6. But he would just get 12s with the resist. Just 12s and 12s and 12s. And I was like, you're my favorite.
Ormond, what's wrong? You haven't seen stuff like this before in your neck of the woods? At any
cost. Oh, we have a dev in a Twitch chat. Is that BFG... oh, hey, look, Red Hook Studios in the Twitch chat.
Oh,
what?
Hey, welcome.
Wubba lubba dub dub. Sorry, I was neglecting Twitch chat. The party names were done. Kickstarter backers. And they're just Flair.
Aw.
You heard it here first.
That's cool, but it makes me kind of sad. I think it would be pretty
the
cool.
Vita. It is coming to the Vita in spring 2016,
yes,
viewers.
That's right. Yeah, they announced that at PSX, I believe.
Yes. Moonman says, thanks for bringing it to the Vita. We're stoked. Cheers. I only saw it for PS4, so that is awesome, because this game on the fly.
Dude, literally it's going to take over my...
like, playing this game.
It will be XCOM until the wee hours of the night at home, and then it'll be like me trying to stay awake on the train
right.
playing this.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, if you are watching on YouTube or... anywhere else on IGN.com, you can head over to our Twitch channel. We have Red Hook Studios, who have so kindly come into the chat. So basically, flood the chat AMA.
Basically, you have to.
Yeah.
It's not optional. It's not an option.
Well, this I'm gonna throw a question at Red Hook Studios.
Go for it.
So early on in the Kickstarter process, there was... and I may be misquoting this, but I'm pretty sure there was a Kickstarter exclusive hero, which was something like the Traitor. Is that still coming? Will that be available as DLC? Let us know.
Good question.
Is that for backers only? Is there any way for non-backers to get that? Or what's up with that?
You know, it's funny because as much as I cowered about this fight, I was like, oh my god.
Also, thanks for gracing our stream with your presence.
Yeah, that's just great.
We're enjoying your game, if you couldn't tell. Playing this on Vita on the Bay Area Rapid Transit, and then losing a whole team, and then strangling the person sitting in the seat next to you.
I can't wait to do that. It's gonna be so fun.
Why did they crit?
I'm gonna go to right exactly. Why crit? This room here is the one I'm just gonna skip. The one up in the corner there with the battle. I'm just skipping that. The one. Skip.
Mango Gaming 44 asks, have you ever played Realm of the Mad God? Yeah, I put some hours
in that game. I have not.
So it's like kind of an 8-bitty light MMO that is now completely riddled and plagued with microtransactions. Although for people who've been playing it, that means more content, so that's fine. But when it first started, it, you would just meet up with your friends, and it's permadeath. So it's kind of like a top-down, almost a twin-stick shooter, but it's played on the keyboard. It's a lot of fun. And the thing I like a lot about it is you start with a couple of basic classes. You go in as like a knight. If you get the knight and the priest to level 10, you unlock the paladin. And then even if you die, so there is some kind of progression even if your character dies, which I love. And I have this story that I'll never forget where me and a bunch of friends in Ventrilo went into this like spider cave or something. And we were all doing pretty well up to this point. And my friend who was playing some kind of spellcaster was like, oh, I got a new scroll. He runs in front of everybody and just opens his inventory. And 2 seconds later, he's mobbed with like 40 spiders and dies and there and sits out for the rest of, like, we played that game for 3 more hours after that because he died so early on. Fun game, F. Thanks for bringing that up.
No, I'm having so much fun with this game. It's been a while since I've enjoyed a game like this.
So Red Hook Studios has an answer to our question, IGN. There is one more class coming to get put in. It's the Merchant class. Which will be free with town events as an update later this year. That's really exciting. There is a Kickstarter backer variant exclusive that's a reskin of the Arbalest into a Musketeer. Ooh.
Oh, cool.
That's really cool. No details on her move set just yet. Cheers. Great. Cool.
Awesome. Thank you.
It's exciting. Man, kickstarting anything is such a roll of the dice because if you get like that, you're the biggest boss if you have that Musketeer for this game. If your Kickstarter, the thing that you decided to back, became a game like this. But I have Kickstarted one too many things to be so naive anymore. Although a game that I'd love to shout out right now that's on Kickstarter, throw them a little love, is a game called Hero Song. It is John Smedley and a lot of the guys from Sony Online Entertainment's new studio,
oh, cool.
Pixel Mage. And it is kind of an old school MMO, but it's also an RPG. There's a lot of there is permadeath, but go check it out. There's a lot of really cool things coming to that game, like emergent AI. When you it's all player hosted servers.
Mm-hmm.
You can turn PvP on or off, so you can join all kinds of different servers. It seems like a community that could, or a game that could create a serious community around it, and I'm very excited for it.
Trying to keep this guy from cracking under pressure here. Where's that nice roll? Give me that nice roll. That's not a nice roll.
Hey, fine. Well, at least you're in the red. I mean, green. Oh, Dan Stapleton was playing this, capturing for the review.
Yep.
I walked into the bay. His one of his characters got crit for 13.
Right.
He tried to heal it with the occultist, rolled to 0.
Yep.
Got the bleed effect.
Yep.
And I was like, I'm just gonna leave.
Yeah.
I've never seen him so visibly like
shaken. Like, yeah. No. It's this game will do it to you. This game really will do it to you. It does not care.
Sounds a little bit like Hank Hill when he's upset.
Oh. This game just doesn't care.
Bobby.
It's just like, nope. We're gonna ruin your day. For fun. Of oblivion. That's why I love it.
Moonman asks, at Red Hook Studios, has porting it to Vita been a hard task? Red Hook responds, we use our own engine and it's been working. We've been working on it for a bit now. I haven't seen it on Vita yet. Only PS4 so far, but so far so good. Time will tell.
Oh, that didn't kill him? I was leaving him alone.
Oh.
That's okay. That guy was...
You're rookie.
That guy was literally brought here to die.
You're rookie real dead. How close are you to finishing the objective?
Very close.
It's, okay, good.
So I'm going
to... It's a hard task to continue on with just 3 people. It really is. Onslaught. Destroy them all. Frederick Arndt says Mario and Luigi Paper Jam is worse than Sonic 06. From what I hear, I think that's probably correct.
I don't know if it's worse than Sonic 06. That's a strong statement, but like,
it's not great.
But yeah, I haven't heard positive things so far. Success. Yeah, I mean, I think, I don't want like famous last words, whatever. I might be okay.
Like, I mean, you only have one more room. Oh, just got to defuse that trap before you step on it.
Whew. There you go. I caught it just in time. But thank you for looking out for me as well.
In Radiance, may we find victory. That Five Nights at Freddy's RPG. Not that great, apparently. Says the Steam reviews. I have not checked it out myself, but who knows? Yeah, I don't really see the appeal of those characters outside of that context. I really like those games. I think they're like...
Yeah?
Yeah. They're fun. Sure, they get a little repetitive at times, but like it keeps you on your toes so much, and there's an interesting story that happens through them. So...
She's killing me. It's these cultists, these cultist enchantresses that just have, 20 dodge? Mm. Or 21 dodge? It's just, it's murdering me.
Game Delay asks, Red Hook, can you spoil whether there will be cross-save, cross-buy on
PS4
and Vita?
That's a great question.
Yeah, Game Delay.
Ooh, hold that! 22 points.
Red Hook says, that's the plan, but we haven't gotten... to that part just yet, so I think they meant to say so no promises,
right?
They said so promises, but how quickly the tide turns. Beyond 25 asks, how long is the game going to be, or how long is it since it's already out? Red Hook responds, we've heard as fast as 20 hours and as long as 50. But we're watching to find out what the total game time is to see if we need to tweak things. I have a question for Red Hook. This, I may just be totally out of the loop on this, but is there going to be Steam Workshop support in terms of like custom campaigns and things like that? I'm not sure how that would really work, but that's something that could be interesting down the line. Or reiterating... who was it who asked it? Moonman's questions of releasing additional content. Or additional status effects. I know you guys just got done releasing it, so kudos to you.
But we want more.
We want more.
We're hungry. Although I still have a ways to go until I'm ready to take on one of the darkest.
That's true.
Ooh, hold that! Hold that! Oh, I feel so good when that happens.
The thing I like about this game is it's a lot like life. Nothing is permanent. The most depressing thing I've ever said. But it's kind of true. I mean, it really gives you...
Oh, wait, I didn't... Ooh. And switch everyone's thing around. Okay, it's fine. Yes, we did it.
Nice. Yeah, I've never run into a scenario where I've scouted a room is clear and there's people. Seem a little so. Less is that the blackjack for the Houndmaster?
Sell it. I don't know, dude.
I've never used that. He has to be in position 2 or closer. So
he doesn't have another stun ability? That you can unlock?
He's just got the blackjack.
I've only ever had one Houndmaster. I loved him.
He's great.
I thought he was great.
Houndmaster's great.
And he was the first... He was in this campaign, he was the first character I lost, I believe. So this is like... As far as the payout goes, this isn't terrible.
I think he's got one of the best marking abilities.
Yeah.
And he can capitalize on that. But oh, so that's what it was. I didn't see anywhere to see how long the mark duration
was. I've got a level 4, baby.
Oh, it's blue.
It's my first level 4.
That's some rare World of Warcraft status. Then he'll be purple, and then he'll be orange.
How are we doing on time?
We got 40 minutes.
Oh, wow.
So we could jump into some other stuff.
Cool. Nice. Pale in comparison to that final crowning
thing. I could not look. I'd really like I'd like something to break up the pace of this game. It's really awesome and a little bit oppressive in the best way. But if there was like some maybe Pokemon Stadium kind of like, you know, you get all your occultists and then you like, oh, who can cut up the octopus and eat it? You know, and you mini games.
I'm not sure if you're trolling or
I'm totally trolling.
I'm pretty sure.
Although
you're trolling,
Pokemon Colosseum mini games are never a bad thing.
No, and I love Pokemon Colosseum. Love Pokemon Colosseum. Not as much as I love Pokemon Snap. But Pokemon Colosseum is pretty good.
I don't think I ever used Pokemon Colosseum for the actual Colosseum. So it's just everybody everybody get the controller, the N64 controller, and rotate it with your palm until you slice your hand open. All right, we got a response from Red Hook. It says, at IGN, we are totally going to do Steam Workshop support. We love mods and are looking forward to supporting them more officially. Awesome. Currently, there are some mods... But they have to maintain things more rigorously since we break things all the time. But with workshop support, it should be easier to maintain community mods. Yeah, and obviously, like, releasing the game is a priority over supporting mods. Support mods after you release the game, so good on you. Red Hook Studios confirms that Pokemon Colosseum was a huge inspiration.
Oh, should I? What's the disease she has? Damn diseases.
Diseases are much worse than negative quirks, but easier to remove.
I don't know.
And I've never seen, I don't think a disease can become permanent. Is that correct?
I don't think it can either.
I don't think I've ever seen one. I really like the... So I have a question for anybody in the chat, including Red Hook Studios. This is more for my own personal knowledge, but once a negative quirk is locked in, it cannot be replaced, correct?
Right.
So getting a negative quirk like is a bad gambler as one of the most benign negative quirks is
yeah,
almost
it's actually,
really good.
It's a benefit
yeah, it's
too.
Kind
yeah.
of a boon.
You cannot look at quirks as like, a, oh my God, I got to get rid of it. The guy can't,
sure,
the character doesn't function
anymore. You want to fill up all of the possible slots.
Fill
with, like,
all those
benign.
Slots with the most like, you know, yeah. just everyone's got their pluses and minuses and you just have to accept that as part of the game. Because if you start spending all your money taking care of that, I don't know about people out there, but like this is where my money has hovered for most of my campaign is in the 20s.
I'm at like 40.
You're at 40 now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I run my shiz like a business. Somebody starts putting me into the negative, and he's not making me money anymore. Gone.
You see, now that's the way you and I used to talk about that back when the game was in early access, and I feel like there's some wisdom to that, but now that we know that the only way that you get to these darkest, the only way you're going to do these darkest dungeons is with a group of sixes.
Well,
I think it's easier. The priority is find a way, like, don't like go bankrupt taking care of one person, but like find a way, like throwing someone out is a big, to me, is now a much bigger decision. Like if I got someone at level 3 or 4, I've put a lot of time and probably
money
into them.
I think we're playing the game in two different ways. I think you're trying to beat the darkest dungeon or a darkest dungeon as quickly as possible. I'm more interested in developing my Hamlet to maximum efficiency and then just turning it into a machine that cranks out level sixes with minimal wear on them, basically.
Right. Let's see if we've got a lucky tank. Yeah, hey, look, another Crusader.
I like the Man-at-Arms a lot, but
Man-at-Arms
will,
probably my
not...
least favorite class
what?
So far.
Really?
I don't dislike him. I don't think he's bad.
So he's
I
will only take
tank.
Him if he has guard. Guard is incredibly
yeah,
clutch, especially
really
if you stack dodge on him mm-hmm. and stuff like that. You buff yeah. yourself. So the rotation for me is you do the thing that triggers your riposte. Riposte, I may be pronouncing that mm-hmm. incorrectly, and then you guard an ally that's at low health, and then, like, best case scenario, they try and hit the low health ally because the AI totally do that, and then you dodge, and then you hit him in the face with the shield.
Right.
It's like the Mac from Always Sunny.
You know what? I am not going to do what I was going to do, which is just do another level 3 with and just throw a level 1 Crusader at it. Like, I don't have a good Crusader, and I feel like good Crusaders are... I like Crusader.
Crusader
does decent starting damage.
He's all right.
Tanky, great against Unholy. He has all kinds of bonus damage against Unholy.
Yeah, he's,
he can do a little bit
like
of healing.
Kind of a damagey character that... he's not... the Man-at-Arms is like a hard tank for me, but the Crusader's great. I the thing that I really like is that, like, the Crusaders excel in the ruins. I prefer the Leper. I like the Leper a lot. It's maybe one of the Corpse Clear is just so clutch, and his heal is fantastic, especially if you're going to roll with something like an Occultist as your healer. Just having a no nonsense way to consistently heal your tank is very good, and
yeah.
he does a ton of damage,
mm-hmm.
and he's got the Hue.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
for like everything except the ruins, I usually like to roll. But I love the Crusader. I like to roll Leopard. Though I just lost my Leopard. He dead.
Oh, that's very sad. I Saudi.
You know, it'd be really interesting if like the Leopard had like a timer about the amount of missions he could last, not just go on, but
that
he's
would
got like 36 missions until he's dead.
I've just noticed another problem that I have to kind of address.
Up.
With my group here, I don't have a low level healer to accompany my lower level dudes that I wanna grind up.
But you have that, yeah. So I mean, do short missions and take.
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do.
I think take your leper because he can heal himself. Yeah, I think you're fine. I think you're fine. If you
yeah, I'm not super worried, and the Crusader can do some healing too. So it's not the hugest deal.
I like sinking, and I'm gonna throw this out. Let's actually read this first. Red Hook says, yes, it cannot be replaced via random new quirks, only by treatment. So you could theoretically get a scenario where you have all the perfect perks locked in and then all the negative perks locked in as well. And you could be the best.
Yeah, that'd be quite an investment of resources to do that, though.
I have not Googled on purpose. I have not looked up optimal strategies.
Yeah, me neither. I want to play this game. I just want to play it my way.
We doing a mission?
Yeah, I want to get some equipment, I think, for
that dude.
Yeah.
So, throwing this question out to everybody watching as well as you, Vince, what do you like to spend your money on first? The first, or your resources just in general? The thing that I used to do
at the start of a campaign?
Right. The stagecoach, but I don't do that anymore. I try and sink everything into the guild and get some abilities, just increase the healing amount on my healers. It's huge.
No, yeah, I would say guild, putting money into the guild hall and putting money into healing skills is worth it. I think one of the first things I do is invest in my infrastructure for taking care of my guys in the tavern and the abbey. Sure. Like, just like having a second slot on some things is really key because the caretaker likes to like chill out in one of them and take one up. So sometimes
I wish I could kill him.
Yeah,
I really do.
Yep.
I'm
with you.
All right.
Okay. So I think
let's rock.
We're good to go. Well, I haven't given anyone trinkets. I don't really care. Who cares?
Although they are pretty powerful, those trinkets.
Let's go to ruins. He's got some trinkets. Oh, that's right. I gave him a very rare one. Actually, I want to give the witch doctor one because I'm sure I'm the plague doctor rather, because I think I've been holding on to something for plague doctor all this time. Plus 40 disease resist, that'll be useful later on.
The people are hungry for blood.
Okay, all right, fine. Let's go. Let's give them what they want. Let's give the people what they want. All right. I don't think I'm gonna. We'll take another one just in case. Where am I going again?
Nah, I don't think you need any blight resist. You're going to the ruins.
Ruins, right? Okay, right. And I don't need a second shovel. This is all stuff I was just given from my dudes.
This is short. I actually do take a second shovel on short because I find I run into at least two of those.
See, I usually only run into one, but then when I don't, it always happens. Yeah, so whatever.
Okay. It's 250 gold at the end of the day. That's much better than like having to pay for treatment for somebody who's cracked.
Yep.
I guess.
But at 250 gold, it is one of the. It is the most expensive.
It is.
That's
yeah.
that's as much as I think you ever will pay for a.
Mega 40 Gaming 44 West asks, "What's your favorite Call of Duty game? Modern Warfare 2." And then after that, I kind of
Call of Duty 2. And then I would say Modern Warfare 1 or 2.
Yeah, to me, it came into its own with Modern Warfare, and I think that there's a pretty good consensus on that in terms of its... Because I do think like the formula is great. I'm not super interested in going back and doing it again. I spent like a ton of hours into Modern Warfare and Modern Warfare 2.
Yeah.
So, good. Why no advance?
What's that?
Why no advance with the 2?
Why don't I advance with
the
2?
Yeah, I guess it'll put your... Leper at range.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
I wish... It's funny because I never really thought about how useful Blight is, but it really is so huge.
Yeah, I think the...
Like here, I could have bled these guys too, but I mean like the...
So I really think that the Plague Doctor is very clutch when you're going against four enemies, not just four. I actually don't even take him with the single target. I take him with Corpse Clear. I take him with the back two Blight, and then I take him with a back two Stun. And then I guess you could take the other Stun, the other Blight on him too, but I think he's best used to hit people in the back, like the back row.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because just the idea that I can dot undead.
Martin Fredrickson says, anyone play Magic the Gathering?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I do. Funny story.
Haven't been a while, but...
I took a lady.
Yeah?
To, actually, she took me to a dying mall.
The best kinds of malls.
It is the best mall in that I've ever been to. It's got a tabletop gaming store. It's got a comic book store. It's got a knife shop. It has an all-you-can-eat seafood buffet. And it's dying in a month. They're closing it. And my heart is broken. I went into the knife store and I was like, so you guys moving after this? He's like, no. I was like, well, why don't you just go on YouTube and like cut up some watermelons or something? He's like, I tried it. So anyway, we went to the tabletop gaming place. They were having a Magic pre-release for, I don't know, whatever the set is coming out now. And we saw this like high school teenager, nerdy kid like me in high school. And he just shook everybody's hand at the table and he said, may you draw well? May you draw well? And we both just went red in the face with the cringiness. And we were like, I'm not going back to that dark place in my in my preteens. But yeah, I love Magic. Magic is great. For me, I enjoy playing Magic most casually in a closed format where I don't need to go buy a bunch of cards and with friends.
Yeah, which is basically the main way I played. Like, back when I was playing Magic a lot, so there weren't enough expansions yet for them to have needed to introduce the idea of, like, I'm sorry. What did they end up? The name, the word of it always goes out of my brain, and I can't remember.
What is it? What are you talking? Sorry, I chased for a second.
There's the different types of tournaments.
Sure.
Some only use a certain set of cards that are more recent than others
modern,
have.
There's modern.
But then there's another that uses standard. That uses a little bit farther.
So the open formats, meaning you can go collect cards, bring them to your tournament and put them in, are standard, modern, and then there's like one or two others.
Standard, modern? Okay, that's not what they were called when I was younger.
No, they've changed them.
Yeah, that's not the word I'm looking for.
I think there may be Legacy or something. There's one where you can use literally any card printed. There's one that's like a little bit more refined where it's like, okay, you've been playing since 96 and you have a huge collection, but we're not going to make you spend $20,000 on a Black Lotus. And that's modern. Where there is like a bans list, and there's like you can't use, like, unlimited is the first set you can use. And then there's standard, which now is just expansion. So new block expansion or new set expansion, new set expansion, new set expansion. They've standardized that format, and you can do up to three of those. So up to three sets is a block, and then cards rotate out. But then there's...
Yeah, that all I know. I'm just trying to think of the name.
Closed, draft... No. Sealed.
No, I know all those. Those are all different kinds of events. I'm just trying to, like, back when I was first starting, there weren't enough expansions where they needed to be like, hey, so expansions from the last 2 years are included, and the current base edition and the last base edition. You know, that was not a...
I think they've changed the name of everything since then. It's crazy that it's more popular now than it has ever been, like, far and away. Which is great. I think it's a great game. I think it's probably, in terms of a tabletop game, if you were going to do nothing but play tabletop games for the rest of your life, I think that Magic would probably be one of the best. It's got a lot of, it's just got a whole community around it. I don't play it because I don't have the time or money to invest. And I get the same experience out of Hearthstone, and I do it
while I'm sitting on the toilet.
Hearthstone is great. If you have played Hearthstone at some point and got a little bit bored of it and went away, now is the best time to play Hearthstone. The League of Explorers did things to the game that I didn't think were possible. Almost every card is playable in ranked.
Really?
Yeah, because of Reno Jackson. A card that heals you back to full health if you have a onesie deck, if you have no more than one copy of a card in your deck.
Uh-huh.
So all these cards that were just like just below viable are totally viable now because of him. When I go into ranked ladder, if this were a year ago, I would see like Freeze Mage, Control Warrior, or Face Hunter. Now there's like 90 different decks you could run into, and it's just amazing.
For now.
Great. Yeah. I'm almost like... Take your time with the next expansion or whatever you do, because it is so great, and I really don't want it to go back.
Right,
to the
you
way
don't
it
want
was.
It to, right, exactly. I mean, as you know, because you and I, you know, you're a man after my own heart in this way, because we both think this way. As you well know, Optimal will is inevitable. Optimal will be found.
Sure, but they've made optimal. They've made optimal and I don't know. They've just taken optimal like this and made it. It's incredible. And honestly, I'm curious to see where they go.
Good thing I took that second shovel. You're right.
The match is struck. Because I don't really know how many more adventures and expansions they can get away with. Because like, if you were new, could you imagine being a new player to Hearthstone right now?
Yep.
Or somebody who played for like a week or two and stopped? Because like, there's like more than 1,000 cards. Thankfully, I've kept up with it the entire time. But like, you know, when I tell people, hey, oh, you haven't played Hearthstone yet? It's like, oh, man, you're going to have to play for, like, months until you even have kind of close to enough cards to maybe think about maybe doing a Legend run. And sure, people like Trump do, like, low investment budget Legend runs, but they do nothing but play Hearthstone all day. And a huge part of getting to Legend is the amount of games you play. It's not just
sure.
how good you are.
Absolutely.
It's a mix between poker and chess. Like, yeah, it depends on your skill, but also there's a huge random element to it. But
anyway. You gotta put the time in.
Back to Darkest Dungeon.
Yes!
You're doing quite well.
I'm doing okay. Doing alright. It's not bad.
Was this a level 3?
No. If this is a level 3, that would be funny. No.
You'd be dead.
So, you know what? I don't know if Red Hook is still in the building.
They may still be here.
But so in pre-release, recent pre-release, I have not hit a single attack with Leper. And like, I know his accuracy is a little bit lower than everyone else's,
that's
but
the chance you take, man.
No, but I've never seen that happen before. I've never been in that.
I bet you'll hit one.
Scenario.
I actually really like using Q with the Leper just because it ends up doing so much more damage, unless there's a single target that I just really need to kill.
But what I was going to say is, at a certain point in the...
Do you think there's a difficulty spike?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. I agree.
At veteran, at level 3, suddenly enemies have 1.5 to 2-ish times the hit points. And which is on its own is fine, right? Like, I feel like on its own that's totally actually okay, because you know, to me, oh wow, so because to me the way that ends up working out is that so they have that much more hit points, and then I don't know who's gonna go first. I don't want to take that damage. And because they have more hit points, that means that they don't get one-shotted. It's harder to mitigate damage when things take longer to kill, right? Like, so
they said, if anything, we buffed his accuracy. I don't know what your problem is. You obviously need to click better,
right?
But whenever I play the Leper, I get kills. He's my
no.
Boy.
I used to also. I like the Leper. I mean, his accuracy isn't that bad. I mean, it's like 75. It's not like
hit one and hit the guy with the shield. You'll hit him right now. Bam.
It's the first hit I've scored.
You just got to will it, man.
You got to... Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah.
It's very it's very zen of you.
You got to believe.
You've got to believe. No, so... Yeah, there's a definite difficulty spike that comes from the fact that... So everyone's got more hit points, which means that it's harder to mitigate damage with offense, right? And that's okay. But then on top of that, they're also hitting harder. So I feel like it's a multiplicative increase in
And I'm not sure if either before release or recently I read something to the tune of they are aware that there's
and then right, we actually got an email from them. Email from them saying like, hey, you know, we kind of heard this feedback from a lot of people, and so we've addressed it, which I think is great. But I actually was wondering like if Red Hook is still around.
Yeah, they're talking.
Cool. I'm curious like what was done to address it? Because I've looked at the patch notes and I don't see anything about like damage numbers or HP numbers or resistance numbers being tweaked for level 3 and above quests or anything. So I was just wondering. Like,
and
what
kind of as a follow up question, this may be a lot to answer once, but like, at what point is something difficult? People are going to complain, and it is at what point is something unbalanced? You know, because a lot like a game with Dark Souls, or a game like Dark Souls in terms of its difficulty, it's like. That's part of the appeal is, it is really difficult, and you really have to, I don't know.
I love that this game is hard.
I don't have enough experience at 3 to speak to it, so.
3 was where I started to feel like, even if I made, like, good decisions,
You know, like the number game was just too much of a peak to crest at times.
I do know.
It didn't seem impossible. It just seemed way like I felt like if I made the same smart decisions as I made before,
sure,
it kind of still wouldn't be. It would be maybe barely enough, if it was enough. And I'm not sure if anything specific was done to kind of address that or not. Either way, the game is obviously still fun, and
yeah,
so that's all that matters.
I've sunk an enormity of hours into it, but I do find myself kind of... I sunk a lot of hours into it over the course of its development cycle, but then always when I would get to like 3 or 4, I'd be like, I'm going to wait until it's finished. And now I'm finally on my way to the Darkest Dungeon. But oh, man, she has the most optimal... Oh, yep. No, she doesn't. She's missing the second skill, Illumination. I always keep her in position 4.
Yeah.
So I just prefer her to have.
Yeah, but she's pretty close to optimal.
Yeah, she's real good.
And I was saying I need a low level.
She's got Slugger though. Whatever, it'll get replaced. That's the thing about positive quirks is even if it's not.
Yeah, as long as it's gonna. Oh no, she's obsessed with food.
Redhook says sometimes it's a learning thing. Once a player learns more, the unbalanced becomes just a difficulty curve. WRT, I'm not sure what that means. Tuning of level 3 dungeons. It was a slight HP reduction, resistance tweaks. Tuning in level 3 dungeons, it was a slight HP reduction in some places and a slight damage tweak here and there.
Gotcha. Okay.
Yeah,
that's what I figured. That's all I think. That's all I thought it needed. I really didn't think it needed much. It just needed maybe that's exactly what I felt it needed, actually. Just a slight reduction in the HP bonuses that the monsters were getting, and maybe a slight reduction
in
some of the
damage.
Hey, I
know this is your personal save file, but we do have 15 minutes. I think we should try level 3 dungeon and succeed.
Sure, let's do it. We can totally do it.
Go ahead and toss it. It looks like you got a pretty good roster there.
Yep.
And you have some, we haven't messed too much with the items. You should probably show people like how you do that and then jump in relatively quickly because we are kind of running out of time. But
cool. All right. My continuing problem is that I don't have a level 3 tank of any kind, but, you know, we can maybe solve that problem by just getting someone off the stagecoach.
I wouldn't do that. I think it's better to take the bounty hunter in position 1 than take a level 0 tank. Like, because then you're setting your other 3 characters up for failure.
For failure, yeah. I agree.
And I don't think tanks are like... tanks are not, unless you have a man at arms, they're not. It's not like they're taunting. They're just a tanky body. So.
Right. So, I'll run this gimmick that I run. She's got.
Have you upgraded your Vestal's healing?
Yeah.
Oh my god! In the AoE heal, it makes all the difference in the world.
Yeah, it's huge.
If you can consistently heal for 3, it's like enormous.
Let's see who's gonna be in the back line. Should I be the Vestal or should it be the Doctor? You know what? I'm gonna bring the Doctor along because he's in good shape and he's level 4, so he'll be able to stand up to things a little bit better. And then who's gonna be my behind?
Is that gonna be consistent enough healing? Probably. You're probably fine. Maybe the Arbalest. Does the Arbalest have any healing on it?
I don't have my any heal on my Arbalest. But
you need a second person.
I need a second person.
Can your guy mark?
Yes, he marks. Yeah, he marks. Okay. So that's.
I would take the Arbalest because then you have maximum efficiency with your marking. You mark somebody, then
yeah,
you
but
shoot
the
and get bonus.
But the
bonus
Arbalest
damage.
Has to be in the back row, one of the back 2 rows, and
sure,
she's not going to be.
Why not?
Oh. The Jester is going to move to the back row.
All right. Well, then Damas is pretty.
I think that was kind of where I was leaning.
Great. He's pretty versatile. All right, so this is a medium veteran 3.
Okay, everyone's got relics of everyone's got trinkets of some kind on.
Great. And let's just provision the crap out of it,
yep.
And then we'll roll.
What do you think? What should we do? Should we do this?
Let's try that boss, man. Well, unless you really don't want to lose your character.
Yeah, I really don't want to lose my character.
Okay,
not to mention the fact that it'll take a long time for me to get to that.
All right, that's fine.
Minutes.
Yeah, let's do that.
We'll do this.
90% of rooms 1.
Oh, but that one's a medium as well, so that's going to be long. I'll do this one. I'll do the skirmish one because it's short.
Okay.
I want to do a short one because we only got so much time left.
Bum, bum, bum. Here we go.
Sweet.
So we got some talk going on with Red Hook. I'm going to read it before my battery dies on my computer. I'm actually going to scroll up. There's, I've overlooked back. Some. And what better place to be in Alrighty. Than the seat of our noble line. Pie in the Sky asks, do you think that the secret room is too accessible? Red Hook says, maybe. It's helping the economy, and they are mostly accessible in long runs, which people tend to avoid. Which we like seeing more people do long runs. Well, I usually play minimal weeks possible and do all long runs. Moving on. Blah, 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 blah.
That is such a killer when that happens to me.
What?
When they dodge
oh,
the,
yeah.
the finale.
I mean, that's what...
It just destroys me.
Yeah.
It just destroys me.
And I at least take some, like, bleeds with him. I think not having other damaging abilities on him is one of your main DPS sources. Because even if he hits, he gets rid of one guy, and then he's debuffed and in the back row. So,
yeah, but then he's doing his songs. That's what I don't need him to damage from the back row.
Okay. Game Delay says, hoping that you were careful about being more inclusive of demonic minorities in your dungeon. Don't want a world unfairly dominated by tentacle beasts and spiky pigs. Red Hook says, we'll try to be more inclusive of our demonic friends.
That's pretty good. Three misses.
Kind of to what we were talking about. Unbalanced is when the comments are frequent and consistent on a certain point. Even then, we watch it more first before pulling triggers. It's tough because our spreadsheets are so massive, so slight changes can have drastic impacts.
Sure.
So we like to do incremental steps and measure again.
That's the smart way to do
so
it.
So with regards to damage, yeah, it's a 1-2 points of damage is our first step. HP might allow a bit more allowance to do larger changes. Pie in the Sky says, what are your observations about new camp skills? I mean, the revamped camp skills. So far, there are people who grumble about change, but overall, we think it's an improvement. The camping skills now give real options to heal or buff. Yeah, I like that a lot. I think the thing that I like most about camping is, like, if your party is really low on HP, you can recover from that. If they're really
yes.
stressed, you can recover from that, but you can't recover from both.
Right. I like
and
that
I
too.
Think that's what I like, too. And then also, if, like, you're doing pretty well, and I love that I can spend my points
yeah.
to buff and prevent an item attack.
Yep.
As well as, totally. Like, increased scouting chances. Camping is a great, great dynamic. For the heal skills were too weak. With right party setups, you can remove afflictions via camping that wasn't possible before. Before this, I didn't even see afflictions in camping. I'm not sure. For the first time, I like cured a blight, which. But anyway. Yeah, so there's that.
Man, that damage is terrible.
Yeah, I always just go with his three shot burst. Just because, like, the damage is so similar to the one shot burst. His bleed, I think, is what really, like, tossing a bleed on that guy in the front is pretty advantageous, especially since it stacks and refreshes. That's a really quick way to bring down those biggins. There you go.
That's how that's supposed to work. Thank you.
I like the gesture in theory, but relying on crits is tough unless you really are stacking.
Well, it's not really relying on crits. Just that because not only does that have a crit on it, that's a +50% damage modifier.
No, I know.
+50%. So that means
but his
that
base damage isn't that crazy to begin with.
Well, it depends on if you upgrade his weapon. Jesus, I'm just not getting any of the rolls I need.
There's a good roll.
That's what a roll I really. I'm not going to be able to finish him, probably. I'd rather just kill this guy.
Yep, I think that's a good call. Surges as the enemy crumbles. Game Delay says, sorry for being unclear. When you have damages in the hundreds, then can you move things by 1 or 5 or 50? Lower numbers one of the smallest increments possible. Do you ever move things by less than one? Well, we can do things smaller than one, and we do. The numbers in game are truncated and rounded, even though there might be fractions at play. That's interesting.
Yeah, that is.
Red Hook Studios likes the gesture. Red Hook Studios, what is your least favorite class? Checkmate. Answered that question. The greater the
glory. That's a tough one.
Well, I guess it's going to come down to his personal subjective least favorite.
Sure. This is looking rugged.
Whoever's behind the wheel.
I don't usually do this, but like, I just feel like we're in such bad shape right now.
Was that your first? Oh, I got 3%. Gotta answer it quick, Red Hook. I'm running out of batteries on my laptop. We do have 6 minutes left on the stream. If you have any last-minute things you want to say, the best way for me to see them is to tweet them at IGN with the hashtag IGNPlays. We have a new tweet from Potato King. Says this game is going to turn my life into the Darkest Dungeon when it's on my PS4 and Vita. And then Enzo Benzi says, have you guys noticed the Plague Doctor looks a lot like the Plague Knight from Shovel Knight? So the Plague Doctor's whole aesthetic is based upon the apothecary mask from ancient times. The long, long ago.
Yes.
The before time. Probably Crusaders. Not that they are bad, but I love others more. I just love them the least. It's a very political answer. Well done. I think a Plague Doctor would be doing work right here. Because that back line is so monstrous in terms of its stress damage.
Yeah.
And, like, blighting them. What's crazy about the Plague Doctor is if you successfully blight twice in a row, that's 8 damage a turn with refresh duration. So it's at the beginning of the game, I think you look at a Plague Doctor and you're like, well, this guy is kind of weak because, like, by the time his dot really starts kicking in, everybody's already dead. But once you get enemies with higher health, I feel like those stacking dots are just really good. And I was wondering why they start you with the Plague Doctor, because it seems like such a niche choice, but he's really bread and butter DPS for the back line.
Yeah, we're in major trouble here.
Yep.
Not having a tank is just, it's not possible. Like, you need an actual tank.
Nah, man, I really feel like your occultist is, I don't know, the Vestal, I always do progression with the Vestal, just because, like, imagine if you could heal everybody in your party by 4 right now for the next 10 turns.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, that helps a lot.
And also, I'm not sure how much synergy is going on in this party. Slowly, but, yeah.
Gently. The problem is that all these dodges, like, honestly, I've never had so many bad rolls where just, like, all the stuff on the jester is just missing and missing and missing. And that's not usually what my experience is.
Do you have, like, a lot of negative quirks that are affecting accuracy? Or?
I don't know. Actually, maybe.
See, he's got 0... He's got 81 accuracy, so he's a little bit debuffed, but not too bad. What's your gesture at? Well, I guess you can't select him until...
Okay.
Yeah, his accuracy mod is minus 15 right now.
Oh, yeah, that's got to have something to do with it.
So that's Lazy Eye, and then that's also... He gets a minus accuracy mod from doing
Finale.
Oh, it's
just right now. Right. It's just right now.
The only times that I've used Finale are, like, when I have the fight almost all but wrapped up. It's really cool when it kills one guy, but, like, I don't know, relying on it for a large amount of damage is... That's a crazy debuff that it gives you.
Well, the idea is that like you can't miss a buff spell though. You know what I mean? Like I can't like I go to the back and I'm debuffed, but like it doesn't matter because
sure.
I'm back there.
Yeah, it's a cool thought. I get it.
I don't know what to do.
Game Delay says thanks for the awesome stream, IGN. Good luck.
Oh, thank you,
Red Hook Studios. Good luck, Red Hook Studios. Super excited to see this on PlayStation. Yeah, I just want to thank Red Hook for taking the time to drop by and answer some questions.
It is
impromptu interviews
great.
Are my favorite.
It is seriously great.
Yeah, that is really, really awesome. You can catch this stream every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday.
Not Monday, sorry.
Every Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. I used to run this thing, I should know. and then you can catch our secret stream Sunday at 2 a.m. There's nothing here Sunday at 2 a.m. Don't come
Do
here.
Not come then. We love you. We love
yeah,
you too
we
much.
We stream all kinds of games here. Sometimes we have developers in. This time we had a developer in our chat, which was sick. but sometimes we have them sitting like right here. and we ask him questions, and if they try and dodge the questions, then we have a bouncer at the door. You can't see him right now, but he's a very large, muscular fellow. Yeah, we ask him questions. We preview games. We check out early access. We also play games like this, which you've already released. And thank you guys so much for joining the stream. Let's want to try and wrap this. We'll wrap this fight up and then we'll close. Even if we go like a minute over or something.
Yeah, sounds good. If I can wrap it, we'll see. We'll see the way things have been going.
I think it's safe to say that this dungeon is probably not. Wouldn't get finished if we continued.
Oh no, no way.
Which you have no choice but to continue. You're gonna do your own save. Thanks for sacrificing your personal save, by the way. It would be very difficult for me to do
that. It is my pleasure. I am here to entertain you and everyone at home. But yeah, this has been rugged. So many.
And there's New Game Plus after all this.
I can't wait. I can't wait until 2 years from now when I'm just a drooling idiot. All I do is play this game. Let's see how many turns.
Man, that battery. The battery on this MacBook was perfectly timed. Or it's at 0% right now. I'm still seeing everything. World 789 says, okay, see you, IGN.
Bye, guys.
Goodbye, World 789.
Hopefully we can kill something here. Please kill something. No, I can't. Oh, it's because I'm in the front row. Life. I can't bleed you. All
right, I think safe to say that we may not lose this fight, but it's probably not going to wrap up in time. So.
Nope. Sorry.
For all things Darkest Dungeon, for all things gaming, and for all things RPGs, keep it right here on IGN. See you later.
Thanks, folks.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to IGN Plays Live. My name is James Duggan. This is Vincent Genito.
Hey!
And we are playing The Darkest Dungeon.
The Darkest Dungeon. You remember our venerable house.
Oh, look.
Hey!
Problems already.
Yeah!
Hit that alt-enter joint. There you go.
There you go.
So, during this whole stream, if you have any questions or comments for